Hi, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making Toastada pizza. And I'm going to show you the easiest and quickest way of satisfy your crave for this pizza. And here I have all ingredients ready. So here I have black beans. So first of all, I'm going to make the black beans mixture. So I'm going to heat up the pan here, and here I have some vegetables. I have a red and green bell pepper, onion, and I'm going to make the mixture. Heat up oil, maybe 1 or 2 tablespoons, and I'm using extra virgin olive oil. The first thing I'm going to add is a garlic paste. Saute it lightly, and I'm going to add onion, so red onion, or you can use any cooking onion. Saute them together for a little bit. Add salt to taste, and now I'm going to add this bell pepper, the green bell pepper and a little bit of a red bell pepper, and saute all these vegetables for a little bit, about half of a minute or a minute or so. I can already smell great here. And here I have these black beans. I'm going to add not all of it, but about I'm going to keep a little bit for my later use. Now if you wish, you can make it more spicy, but it's really up to you. So I'm just going to add just a little bit of red chili powder, and look at how it looks already gorgeous. Add just a little bit of water, and now I'm going to give a good smash here. So make sure that you make kind of a mixture that you can easily spread on pizza, and make sure to now cook it till all the water is evaporated. If you have a nice boiled black beans, you can easily prepare this mixture in no time. All right, so this is how you wanna prepare it. So this is done, turn off the stove. All right, so we have our black beans mixture ready. And here I have this pizza crust, ready pizza crust, pre-baked. You can use the homemade, or you can use the store-bought, or you can bake in advance and then have that ready anytime whenever you crave for this pizza. And today here I have this pita bread, actually, so you can use even pita bread. Make sure that it's thin, it's not too thick, so that's all we need. So basically you can use any kind of crust, but make sure that it's not too thick. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to spread this black beans on it. So on top of it, just spread the thin layer of this black beans. Make sure to spread it all over. All right, and now on the top I'm going to sprinkle the cheese. So this is good enough. Now it's not necessary that you have to have a pre-baked crust. You can even start from the scratch. You can make your own crust, and then you don't have to even bake. You can you don't have to pre-bake. If you are making from the scratch, you can make it either way, but I find really easy this way. So here I have this ready, and I'm going to pop this into the toaster oven. I'm going to turn on this toaster oven at 350 degrees, and all I want is just that I wanna melt this cheese. So just pop into the toaster oven, and I'm going to bake till the cheese is melted. Here I have some fresh slices of avocado, and of course I'm going to sprinkle some spring onion, the green onion, and I'm going to need Southwest ranch or dressing. And I have this homemade. You can watch the video for homemade Southwest, spicy Southwest dressing. Now when you eat at California Pizza Kitchen, you will see that they have some corn chips, the corn kind of this chips on the top. Sprinkle looks so great. So I also fried some corn tortilla chips to sprinkle on top. I just cut them into stripes and then fried, but you can use even the ready corn chips or Fritos. You can use anything on the top. And I will need some more salsa and some more ingredients once this pizza is ready. And also I will need some lettuce, the fresh lettuce. You can chop fine or just roughly chop anyhow you like. This pizza is ready and ready to come out of this toaster oven. So turn off the, and I'm going to bring it down onto this plate again. So look at this nice looking pizza. It looks already nice, but we're going to decorate a little bit more here. Now you can top it up however you like, but I'm just going to sprinkle lettuce and those corn chips. And if you wish, you can also again put some more vegetables on it, but I usually do not add much on the top because you don't want to load this pizza with so much of stuff on it. Now when you are using the ready crust, you don't have to even melt this cheese, but I kind of like a melted cheese rather than just using the cheese just as it is. But if you like it, you don't have to even turn on this mini toaster oven even. You can just top it off your ready crust and then ready to eat. The first thing, I'm going to make the layer of lettuce like that. And now I'm going to drizzle the Southwest dressing on top. You can make it a little bit more liquidy if you wish. And the most important is I have here the green onion, the spring onion basically, and I like a lot of it. I'm just going to sprinkle this chips, the fried one, on top like that, and then just cut it and ready to serve. But before that, I'm going to put these slices of avocado on the side. I'm just going to, you can put it on top if you wish, but I'm just going to arrange them on the side like this. And look at this plate, already looks nice. Oh, don't forget to pour a little bit of a salsa even, brings out the nice flavor. So here I have this plate ready. Look at this, how beautiful it looks already. And I'm ready to dig into it. If you wish, you can put some of the red bell pepper just for the good look. Bite. It's such a great thing to have some variation for pizza even. So this was all about California Pizza Kitchen inspired Toastada pizza. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.